Yo, what's going on, man? Today we're going to be talking about an update that's coming to Black Ops 4. I usually don't do stuff like this, but this one is a madness. Get the first set of DLC weapons in this game, which I cannot wait for, which I will go into with it in this video as well, and I will be describing everything that's coming in this update. As you guys can see on screen right now, with this black market, we've had the battle pass, which is the Operation First Strike, where you can get all these different things in terms of like reserves. You can get different outfits, you know what I'm saying, like face paints and stuff like that. Realistically, I think it was a bit of a letdown. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty sure that's what the majority of people feel as well, just because the outfits, oh no bro, why are they all so weird? Like, look at that. What is that, man? Like, realistically,
what is it?
Like, I don't get like the theme of the outfits in this battle pass. I don't get it. I don't get what that's supposed to be. You know what I miss, man? I know it might seem it shouldn't seem a little bit far-fetched at all. Remember in Black Ops 3 when, you know, you did all the challenges for each of the specialists and you get the hero armor, like the gold armor, bro? Where's that sort of stuff? We're getting some war paint type of, I don't know. When you're playing, you don't really see your character. You literally, like, only other people see your character. This isn't like Fortnite where it's third person. You don't even see your character, you know what I mean? So I don't really understand the point of everything. You see everything in, like, the black market right here is outfits. It's outfits and gestures. No one uses gestures, first off. I don't know why you're going to do that in a gunfight. Like, the gold armor in Black Ops 3, you could flex with that. I'm not flexing with Bene Valencia. Like, yeah. Anyway, we're going to get into all the information about this new update that will be coming pretty soon to Black Ops 4. Before we do, though, you know, if you just want to see some better stuff, make sure you drop a like on this video real quick. I know you guys can do that. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel as well. Like, please do that. I'd appreciate it. Do you know what I mean? Subscribe to the channel. If you're seeing this, you know what I'm saying? Because YouTube is completely broken right now, but it's cool. Alright, so we're gonna get into this right here. I will probably like hop into some games after I talk about this quickly. I just want to make sure I get all of the information across to you guys, because this is gonna be a pretty big update, which will be coming soon. And when I say soon, I mean next Tuesday, which is the 11th of November. And there's actually more updates coming soon after that with new implementations, which I will get into as well. By the way, I know I don't usually do this type of stuff, but I just thought I'd do it because it's a big change coming to Black Ops 4. And I know like a lot of people have been talking about it. A lot of people have been a little bit annoyed with the way like the black market is working currently and how Operation First Strike went down with like the items that you had. But anyway, the new operation is called Operation Absolute Zero. Now, this introduces the first post-launch specialist. I'm sure you guys have heard of that as well. You've seen different images. They've actually put like teaser trailers out and stuff like that. It's called Zero. Now, the description of this is a versatile and deadly hacker available in both multiplayer and blackout. In multiplayer, Zero can disrupt and distract her enemies using her powerful hacking tools at her disposal, bringing new counteractive measures to the table in Black Ops 4. Now, personally, I don't really understand what this means. If like I was to take a wild guess, you know, hacking and stuff like that, I would imagine, I don't know, it's some sort of like EMP in a sense, because I saw like the teaser trailer, it had like an EMP in its hand, so maybe you can throw an EMP and stuff like that to counteract the equipment that the other specialists have. And not only that, I'm thinking, bro, I don't know if you guys remember in World War II, I'm hoping it's not this, but maybe like, I don't know, if you use something that like blocks the enemy UAV if you're near them, I don't know, something along those lines. It could be wrong, but let me know what you guys think of that. But also, you're able to get this by, or at least you unlock Zero by completing tier one in the newly revamped black market, and then you can use it straight away. So it's not difficult to get. You don't have to get to like tier 20. You pretty much get it straight away as soon as this update drops, once you complete tier one in the new battle pass. Now, not to mention, another big thing is a new DLC weapons. I'm pretty sure that's why the majority of you guys clicked on this video. We're actually getting three new weapons in this update. Three new weapons. We've not seen any DLC weapons yet in this game. I thought maybe it might be too early to see new DLC weapons, but nah, they're going all out. I hope you really do like carry on to update the game, you know, consistently and quite frequently as well, because I would enjoy that. I'm pretty sure that's what Call of Duty needs at this moment in time. So like I said, we're getting three new weapons. We've got the Damon 3XB SMG, which I have no idea what it is, but if I show you guys this image on screen right now, this could be what we're going to see as a DLC weapon. It kind of looks like the AK-74U from like Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 3 when it was brought back as a DLC weapon. I'm not too sure. Let me know what you guys think. If they do bring back the AK-74U as the Damon 3XB, I would not mind. But like I said, from the looks, it's kind of looking like the AK-74U type of weapon. That's a submachine gun. Also, we've got the SWAT RFT assault rifle. This was in, well, there was a SWAT in Black Ops 2, which was a burst rifle. Now, obviously, because it's an assault rifle in this game, or it's supposed to be an assault rifle in this game, that means it's not going to be a burst, which means, I don't know, it might just be like a fully automatic version of the SWAT that we saw in Black Ops 2, which was a burst, or maybe it's like a different weapon altogether. Do you know what I mean? With just like a similar name. I'm not too sure. Let me know what you guys think of that, but we're getting a new AR, a new submachine gun so far, and we're also getting a melee weapon, which which is called The Secret Santa. I have no idea what that's going to be, but I'm kind of excited to hear all these DLC weapons, because I don't know if you guys remember, like, when Black Ops 3 was in its prime, and even after, bro, even when World War 2 was out, they were dropping DLC weapons kind of consistently. But they could do that on, like, more of a consistent basis with this game, and even maybe even more frequently, man. I'm hype. I'm honestly hype. You know, they usually do, like, a couple weapons and a melee weapon, and then that might be what we're going to see in this game. In addition to new weapons, obviously, we're getting, like, new weapon camos. We're getting new reactive camos. If you don't know, that's for, like, certain variants of the weapons. We're getting new reticles and stuff like that. You can also use these weapons if you don't get them in the battle pass. If you don't, like, rank up enough, you can use them straight away in a new game mode they're bringing into the game, which we have seen before, I believe, in, like, Black Ops 3, which is called Blackjack's Gun Game, which is where it's, like, you know, different weapons, different variants and stuff like that. So you'll be able to use these DLC weapons in that gun game as well. And just to quickly mention, if I didn't mention already, you get these weapons in the battle pass in the new Operation Absolute Zero. So that's how you get them. I don't know what tier they're going to be. I don't know which one's going to be the highest tier. I don't know, like, what the variants are going to be like. But all I'm saying is I'm hyped for this new operation. This comes Tuesday. I believe it's Tuesday, the 11th of this month, either way, which is hype. There is also, like, more information I could go into about, like, Blackout, about, like, you know, zombies and stuff like that. But if you want to see all that, the link will be in the description. If you want to go check it out, you can read up on all that different stuff. These pretty good updates to that too. But, you know, I don't really want to cover, like, too much. I just wanted to give you guys the main things, you know, because I really do multiplayer. Yo, man, honestly, I'm hyped for this. I'm hyped for the content. I'm hyped, you know, just to see new stuff in the game. And that's not even to say that I was bored of it, man, because realistically, oh my, I knew that was gonna be a close fight. Realistically, this game isn't even, like, I'll be real, I didn't expect anything new in this game yet. Oh my god, I didn't expect anything new in this game yet, but they've done it, or at least they're doing it. There's people, bro, he's like, what, bro? Yo, I'm backing up, my teammates are nowhere near me. Yo, throw this, let's go. Let's go. I was going to follow it for a split sec. Oh, nah, he's up top. But yeah, man, I'm hyped for this. I don't see anything negative about this. One thing to mention, actually, is the fact that, okay, we got a recon drone, so I should be pick up this. Where did... One thing to mention is the fact that it's going to be 100 tiers instead of 200 tiers. You know, people were complaining about that, but then I realized probably it's a good thing. Because if you think about it logically, right, if we're getting, like, the same amount of, like, good things in 100 tiers, that just means... That realistically just means we're... Wow, I just, can I run? Can I run, please? I can't tell if I'm being chased. In, like, if I'm thinking positively, it just means we're getting, like, good stuff quicker. All right, no. Okay, I'm pushing the spawn. Let's go. Oh no. Do I carry on pushing? Bro, he's gonna jump down. Clown, you shouldn't have done that. Anyone else here? I don't think there is. Okay, whip out the UAV. I'm trying to talk, but don't think. Bro, teammate, you jack. No, no, no. Okay, I got my streaks, bro. If I would have died just now, I'd have been heated. I'd have actually been heated. All right, so we got the streak. Basically, yeah, I just see it as we're getting stuff faster. So if the DLC weapons are in, you know, the battle pass, the operation thing, we're going to be getting those weapons a little bit quicker than we would say. I don't know, like the ICR, for example. I don't know, it might take longer to level up. But what I'm saying is, say if there's a weapon at max tier, it won't take a whole 200 tiers to get that weapon. Oh, they're all spawning there? It won't take a whole 200 tiers to get that. No, man! That's basically what I'm trying to say. There's a guy up top, bang, bang. Swear this. What the flip? That's an enemy right next to you, big man. 29-1, 29 KD. I'll take that. Whilst talking as well. Okay. Yeah, it's going to be 100 tiers instead of 200 tiers, which in my opinion is a good thing. And it also symbolizes that maybe they'll be updating the game a lot more often than they were initially intending to. Meaning, you know, if it is working the same way in terms of like how fast you go up the tiers, maybe they're planning, okay, people will do this a lot quicker than obviously the 200 tiers. So we're going to be updating the game a lot more often. That's like, you got to figure the positive side sometimes. Yeah, man, let me know what you guys think. I'm hoping there's huge changes to this, because look at this, man. This just isn't good enough, personally. I don't think it is. Like, look at that. Like, what are these outfits, man? I don't get. There's no good ones yet. And maybe it's because it's so early on. I can understand that. Maybe they're planning on doing things, but not too early in the game. No, it makes sense. I just want to see some changes. I want to see some more variants, you know, in this featured item section and the daily item section, just because, you know, outfits aren't really too crazy in Call of Duty. I mean, it's cool to have an outfit to flex and stuff, but it's not like these. Like, we don't care about these ones. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know how you guys feel about all this different stuff, all the new stuff coming next week. But yo, thanks for watching. watching, man. Hopefully YouTube sends this out, which I highly doubt. It's just been annoying recently, man. But yo, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one, man. Peace. Shout out my label, that's me. I'm in this bitch with TB. I'm in this bitch with 4Trey. I just pulled up me a 8. Real nigga all in my face. 500 racks in my safe. 500 racks to the plug. What you know about showing love? What you know about pulling up? It been